Hello YouTube! So, I've been playing a game called Bot Vice, and I kinda dig it. It's this retro-style shooty, dodgy, slashy, fighty thing by DYA Games, who also made Super Star Path, a game I wasn't actually that crazy about, but which intrigued me by being a combination of a shmup and a match-the-colors puzzle game. This game follows that tradition of fusing multiple game styles together by being sort of a bullet hell by way of Mega Man. Okay, actually, when I say Mega Man, really the comparison begins and ends with the art assets. The game it most closely resembles is Cabal, with some Time Crisis thrown in for flavor. You play a cyborg police officer in a plot that itself is kind of a weird fusion thing, combining elements of RoboCop, Die Hard, and Mega Man. See, there's this guy who's holding a building hostage. He's gonna blow it up in less than an hour if his demands aren't met. And the main character, Erin Saver, no really, that's her name, has to shoot her way through 25 levels and 4 boss fights to get to the building in time. Now, that time limit is actually tied to a cool game mechanic. The total of your clear times for all the preceding levels have to be less than the time limit, otherwise you can't go on to the final boss fight at the end. I like this. It organically encourages players to go back and retry previous levels to get better clear times. And as long as we're talking about game mechanics, this game has a hefty amount of them. Some have even said too many. You see, the player moves left and right only along the bottom of the screen and avoids taking damage either by ducking behind degrading cover, dodge rolling, or slashing the bullets with a light sword, Ubermosh style. Robots appear on a set schedule during each stage, with dozens of different robot types, each having unique styles of attack and defense. You'll have your basic hand blaster to attack them, as well as the ability to lock onto nearby enemies, and you can collect additional weapons from gold robots that pop up occasionally in the level. Your sword can be used on any enemies that get too close to your cover wall. Each stage has a boss, and the trick with the bosses here is to focus on them even when other robots are coming out to support them, because the quicker you put the boss away, the better your grade, and the better your chances of getting into the final area. Now, if you're a fan of hard retro games, this will not disappoint you. In fact, it's hard right out of the gate, almost to a fault. Players are given a quick tutorial to explain all the mechanics and then thrown right into the fray. Even the first level is virtually guaranteed to kill you at least once or twice while you're getting the hang of the mechanics. And to be fair, levels restart quickly after death, so you aren't waiting around to try again. I'll admit, dying can be a little frustrating in this game, at least at first, but once you get the hang of the dodging, the slashing, and the taking cover, you're going to find yourself beating levels in no time. Now, that said, there are a couple things I'm not crazy about. I feel like the range on the sword makes it all but completely useless as a weapon. You see, enemies in range of the sword are also close enough to start shooting without you being able to see their fire, and that kind of makes it hard to defend against them. The lock-on mechanic also does take some getting used to. In fact, most of the negative reviews I've read say the lock-on is frustrating. Now, I didn't find this to be the case. Personally, for me, the lock-on worked just as I expected it to, based on how it was described during the tutorial. And there's actually tactical advantages to not using the lock-on in certain situations. So, results and tastes may vary there. One thing I am definitely not liking, some of the stages have invincible cover for the enemies to hide behind. Now, I realize the tactic in these cases is to use a grenade, however, switching between all the different weapons in a fast-paced, bullet-riddled, visual cluster fudge of a game like this is already annoying. So I found that any tactic that required a specific weapon was just frustrating to execute. This janky weapon switching also made the flame gun annoying to use, even though it was a very effective weapon against mid-range tanks and bosses. Still just very frustrating to just run across it while you're trying to flip to a different weapon. All things considered, and given the price, I can definitely recommend adding this to your Steam library. My advice for first-time players, be patient with yourself. Concentrate on learning all the ways you can defend yourself, and get familiar with the way the lock-on works. Remember, you can take your finger off the lock-on button and then press it again to lock onto a different enemy. Once you get familiar with the way the lock-on chooses enemies, you'll have no problem making good tactical use of it. Also, get familiar with the tactic of slashing bullets with the sword. This will definitely come in handy during boss fights and against enemies that lob explosives and Molotov-style weapons. Finally, I highly recommend you use a controller with this game. The game allows you to remap buttons in the settings, which I needed to do because pushing up to duck just didn't feel right. So I found I was using cover much more effectively when I switched the cover motion to down. Anyways, thanks for watching. I appreciate it, and I do hope you choose to like, comment, and subscribe.